there, friend! Last time we learned 4 different strategies to solve subtraction problems, and today we are going to learn about 1 more tool we can use to subtract numbers. Let's get started! Last time, we listened to stories about numbers and used pictures, counters, and fingers to help us subtract or take away numbers. Today, we are going to turn a number story into a number sentence, just like we did with addition. Do you remember these 2 symbols? This symbol is called a plus sign, and this symbol is called an equal sign. We aren't adding numbers right now, so we don't need the plus sign, but we will need this, a minus sign. This sign tells us that we are subtracting or taking away a number. Let me show you how we use it. Let's start with a number story. Here is Mia with her balloons again. This time Mia had 6 balloons. Oh no, it looks like she let go of some. 2 of her balloons are floating away. How many balloons does Mia have now? To turn this number story into a number sentence, we need to ask ourselves, how many balloons did Mia have in the beginning? In this number story, Mia started with 6 balloons. So we write the 6 first. Just like in addition sentences, we need a symbol next. We need the symbol that tells us to subtract, called a minus sign. Now the number sentence says 6 minus, minus what? How many balloons did Mia lose? Oh, that's right, 2. Next, we need the equal sign because that is the symbol that comes before the answer. 6 minus 2 equals, let's find the answer. Just like addition, we can draw a quick picture to help us find the answer. Our number sentence says 6 minus 2 equals. First, we need to draw a picture of our hole, or the number of balloons Mia had in the beginning. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, how many does the number sentence say we need to take away? We need to subtract 2. To do this, we can just cross out 2 balloons. 1, 2. To find our answer to 6 minus 2, all we need to do is count how many balloons are left. 1, 2, 3, 4. 6 minus 2 equals 4. Our number sentence is complete. Read it with me. 6 minus 2 equals 4. Awesome! Now that we wrote a number sentence together, let's read one and use a new strategy to subtract and find the answer. Here is our number sentence. Read it with me. 8 minus 5 equals. Great! Let's use counters to solve this problem. Our first step is to find the whole, which is always the first number in a subtraction sentence. 8! So I need to start with 8 counters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The number sentence says 8 minus 5. So how many counters do we need to take away? 5! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Great! Look at the counters. I have one set of counters here and another set over here. We broke up our whole into these two parts. Now, to find our answer, we need to count how many counters are left. So that must mean 8 minus 5 equals 3. Good job! Great job today, friend! Today, we practice using the minus and equal sign, writing and reading number sentences, and solving subtraction problems using pictures and counters. Remember, in math, we can solve any problem together. You can count on it. See you next time. Hey.